Good morning to you on this Wednesday. We continue with Mark's Gospel, chapter 9. Yesterday we saw about the transfiguration of Jesus, and today we continue from verse 5. Peter said to Jesus, "Rabbi, it is good for us to be here. Let us make three tabernacles, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah." For he did not know what to answer, for they became terrified. Then a cloud formed overshadowing them, and a voice came out of the cloud. "This is my beloved Son. Listen to him." All at once they looked around and saw no one with them anymore, except Jesus alone. As they were coming down from the mountain, he gave them orders not to relate to anyone what they had seen until the Son of Man rose from the dead. They seized upon that statement, discussing one another what rising from the dead meant. So here we see the disciples, Peter, James, and John, with Jesus, having seen this mighty transfiguration, that Jesus suddenly completely in his glory, and Moses and Elijah standing talking with him, they lost their minds. They didn't really know. Peter, not knowing what to say, said, "Rabbi, it's good for us to be here. Let's make three tabernacles, one for each one of you." He didn't know what to say. He was terrified. Probably would have been better to say nothing. Then a cloud overshadowed them, and a voice came out of the cloud, "This is my beloved Son, listen to him." Here again, God is endorsing Jesus Christ, Jesus, his Son. And he's giving the best advice anyone can ever give. Listen to him. Listen to him. This advice is from the lips of the Father. "This is my beloved Son. Listen to him." What better advice can I give you? What better advice can I give myself? Listen to Jesus. Obey him. It was disobedience that brought about our downfall. Adam and Eve didn't listen to the voice of God. They disobeyed. Sin came into the world. Death came along with it. Jesus obeyed the Father. He was obedient unto death, even death on the cross. And through his obedience, we now have life. The best advice we can give anyone is listen to him. That's why so often I use the prayer, "Take thou my hand and lead me." We need to say to the Lord Jesus Christ, "You tell me what to do, I will listen." We pray for the strength to be obedient, to listen to him, not to listen to the world, to the voices all around us that are getting crazier and crazier every day. No, we listen to him. He speaks to us primarily through his word, and his word cannot be broken. So as the Father said to Peter, James, and John, "This is my beloved Son, listen to him." So he says to each one of us, "Listen to my beloved Son, listen to Jesus." Lord God, Heavenly Father, we choose to listen. We choose to obey. We choose to walk with you. We thank you, Lord, that you have put it in our hearts and given us the faith to make this choice. We realize it is also of you. So to you is all the glory, honor, and praise. As we begin a new day, we commit ourselves anew to you. We ask that you take us by the hand and lead us. We ask that you guide us. We ask that you shape us, mold us, use us for your kingdom, Lord. Help us to walk in your truth. Teach me thy way, O Lord, and I will walk in your truth. Unite my heart to fear your name, and I will walk in your truth. We thank you, Lord, that you love us so very much. We love you, and we ask, Lord, that you would help us to always be obedient to you, to always listen to you. Lord God, Heavenly Father, we pray for our country. We ask for our governments. We ask, Lord, for wisdom. We pray that you would help them navigate through these very strange and difficult times, that they would learn to listen to you and not to the voices all around them. Lord God, Heavenly Father, we pray for the Ukraine. We pray for peace. We pray for an end to the war. We pray for an end to the suffering. So many are suffering. Lord God, have mercy. We lift up before you our loved ones near and far. We ask your blessing over our families. We ask your blessing, Lord, over all who are suffering. We pray for those souls that don't know you yet. We ask that today would be the day they open their hearts to you. We pray for the sick, the dying, those who mourn. We pray for those who are just stumbling around in the darkness, that today would be the day they find the light and come to you. So, Lord, we commend to your care all who need your care. We love you, we bless you, we praise you, we thank you. And now, Lord, we join together in praying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, now and forever. Amen. So my friends, have a blessed day. God be with you. God bless you, and I hope to see you all again tomorrow.